serve a God, praise God. He has got a purpose.
Amen.
Praise God for his people and for the things, praise God, that he is doing in our world today. Praise the Lord. We're going to get into our scripture. We're very long, but I just thank God. I thank God for this ministry. The church has been a blessing and been a help. Praise God.
Amen.
Yes.
But unlike Paul, praise God. Amen. Praise God, there yet. Amen. I'm not content with some of the things, praise God, that's going on. Praise God. I'm looking for a greater day.
Yes,
I'm looking for more.
Yes. Yes.
Praise God. I heard something the other day, praise God, that kind of registered with me a little bit. They say people do the greatest things, praise God, in life. More people, praise God, I forgot what the percentage was, a high percent, like 85%, do the greatest things in their life after 65. I thought, wow. A lot of folks think the older you get, they look forward to that retirement age. But praise God, in reality, praise God, God has put all that experience, all those things down in you, praise God, amen, down through the years, amen, that have really come forth like the cream of the crop. And they say 85%, praise God, of the people in line do the greatest things after 65. And I thought, wow. I mean, that was like mind blowing. I'm thinking, Lord, we're so caught up in in the young society, praise God, of today. We glamorize things, praise God, to the point of, after you're 30 years old, praise God, you kind of over the hill, because sports and all these other things are so glamorized that, praise God, you think, oh, yeah, you look back on life when I was in my 20s and I was in the 30s. What are you talking about? Praise God. The old song you said, please be patient with me. God is not through with me yet.
Uh-huh.
Yes, yes. Praise God. Amen. The wisdom years and the years that really make a difference. Praise God. A lot of folks feel like if they ain't done things by the time they're 25 to 30, praise God, they over here. What are you talking about? Woo! You ain't even really started to understand what God is trying to do with your life. Praise God until you, amen, until you get some experience.
All right.
Behind me. Praise God. Amen. So, amen, that really, praise God, kind of struck me when I heard that comment. Amen. God is good.
Yes, he is.
Yes, he is.
All the time. God is good. If you have your Bible, we're going to the book of Isaiah. I just want to look at one verse in that book, Isaiah 55.
Judah and those divided nations for, praise God,
a number of years. They say he didn't pass away until he was 85 years old. Prophesied through 4 different kings. Amen. Prophesied more about the millennial period, about when Christ was coming back, than any other prophecy. Isaiah had a vision that very few people have. See, your vision in life, praise God, amen, that God gives you. He'll give you a vision, but it's up to you to act on it.
Come on.
That's it now.
He'll give you knowledge,
yes,
but it's up to you to use it.
That's it.
It's up to us. Isaiah seen something and he wrote the church. He said this, he was wounded by transgressions.
Yes.
He was bruised, amen, by our chastisement. He said the iniquity, the sins, the iniquity of sin was laid upon him. I forget that verse. I had it in my mind. I didn't try it, but he's a liar.
Right.
Amen. But the bottom line, he said, by his stripes, we are healed. We are healed. Isaiah had a vision from the church. He said, like sheep, we have all gone astray.
Yeah.
Yes.
He's seen Christ down through the years and down through the times. Mm-hmm. Praise God. Don't miss the opportunity. There can be so many distractions in life that try and take you away from the vision and the purpose that God has given you. Mm-hmm. That if you don't be careful, you can miss it altogether.
All right.
Yes.
Praise God. There are some that don't think that they can miss it. You can miss it.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, no, don't you get yourself twisted. Praise God. The purpose and the vision that God has laid out for us. He said, seek the Lord while he may be found. Call upon him while he is near. See, God is near, praise God, to us all. There's an opportunity today, praise God, to seek the Lord.
Mm-hmm.
Sometimes we think, praise God, everything's kind of going all right. Praise God, everything's kind of going okay, you know. I really ain't got much, praise God, that I need to really totally pray about. Don't let the devil deceive you.
That's right.
The Bible says that men should always pray and faint not. Mm-hmm. Praise God. See, the time that God is near unto his people, praise God, amen, that's the time to reach out, praise God, and ask the Lord, praise God, what is it that you would have me to do?
All right.
Drawing near to God, praise God, is like drawing near, praise God, maybe to a friend or to a relative. Praise God. Amen. Husband or wife. They say that the relationships sometimes kind of go in waves, kind of go up and down. Praise God. Amen. Sometimes you feel a little bit more distant, praise God, to an individual. And other times you feel a little closer to individuals.
Yes. Mm-hmm.
Praise God. Amen. I remember, praise God, on my birthday I had a chance to talk to my mother's only sister, my aunt, praise God, in St. Louis. And I called her up and we began to talk, praise God. And she began to tell me some things, praise God, about family years and years ago. Praise God. Amen. Just about, praise God, a family, what we did. And she could remember, praise God, when each one of us was born and going through. And my parents been, praise God, God's dad been gone for over 20 years. Mother's been gone for 15. But all of a sudden, I began to feel closer to her. And I wanted to get more information from her. Praise God. I wanted to talk to her a little bit more. And praise God, before you know it, the conversation was supposed to be initially like a 5-minute birthday greeting turned into almost an hour on the telephone. And still couldn't quite get enough. See, when you come to God, you start gaining things that you didn't even know that you needed. When you start drawing close to him, he'll start putting things down in you. He'll start giving you that nutrition. He'll start giving you, building your faith, praise God. So many relationships today, praise God, folks look around, well, they don't talk to me, they don't talk to them. Last another way. Praise God. Amen. Husband and wife, praise God, relationship. Praise God, coming in and look around and praise God, don't have that closeness. Praise God, one of the things I like to have, praise God, amen, in the house and whatnot, between our relationship, we try to do, every so often, we try to get together and we try to have a night where we go out at least once a week. Mm-hmm. We got to do it. Mm-hmm. Praise God. Sister Brenda, I don't care how we feel during that week. We got to have that time where we can come together, praise God, because you have that closeness, praise God, that you don't want any distractions to come between
you. Amen. Right.
Amen. Praise God. And God, praise God, in our text, is calling Israel. Israel, it's time, praise God, that you seek me. Praise God. Seek ye the Lord. While he may be found. Whew. While he may be found. Call upon him while he's near. Praise God. Amen. There can be a time, hallelujah, a distance in a relationship. Praise God, a distance that you feel, praise God, with an individual. Amen. I heard Sister West, praise God, First Lady, say praise God. I know we're not supposed to have favorites, but this is kind of my favorite. Amen. And down through the years, you know how family members are. You talk to some a little bit more at that time, and you talk to others a little
That's
bit more
right.
at that time.
Amen.
That's just the way it is.
Yeah.
Praise God. Amen. And but you try and keep that connection, and you try and keep that feeling. You try and keep that, praise God, communication. Keep that line going and keep, praise God, that line flowing.
Yes.
You got to keep the line of communication open.
And that's so true.
And praise God, if you want to build any kind of relationship, you have to keep the line of communication going.
Amen.
Praise the Lord. Amen. The enemy try and block it, try and stop it up, try and say, that's done, praise God, and this is over. But no. Keep that line of communication open.
Amen.
They used to tell us, if you really want a friend, you got to show yourself friendly.
That's mm-hmm. it. Amen.
You got to put yourself out on the line a little bit. You got to show yourself to be a friend.
Mm-hmm.
Praise God. And I think of that scripture, praise God, that said, he's a friend that sticks closer than any brother.
Mm-hmm.
Praise God. That he'll be right there by your side through thick and thin. I don't care what you're going through. Praise God. If you want to build friendship, praise God, let folks know, praise God, amen. You start, amen, building up other folks. You start building up somebody. Pick up right. and built up.
Yes,
praise
right.
that right now.
That's right.
And say whatever you want to say.
Yeah.
They like to be built up.
Mm-hmm.
Praise God. Amen. Folks and boasting, talking, praise God, and in the service industry, I found out, praise God, the more you listen, mm-hmm. praise God, amen. The more attention, praise God, you'll get. Praise God. Amen. That's in any relationship. Praise the Lord.
Yes.
As we build them up. And as seeking the Lord, praise God, while it may be found.
Yes.
While he's near. It gives a tone that he may not always be near. You see that? While he is near,
mm-hmm.
he may not always be near. You know, there are some times in the scriptures, amen, I'm going to look it up, but there are some times, praise God, in the Old Testament, where God said, you're going to call on me in this day, and I'm going to laugh at you. You're going to call on me, praise God, and you're not going to get no response. You're going to be calling out, praise God, amen, and wondering, where is the Lord? Hallelujah. But see, this is the day, praise God. This is the time, praise God, to seek the Lord while he is near.
Yes.
Opportunity of a lifetime. Praise God. So Isaiah, praise God, was trying to get those to understand. Praise God. Take time out. Praise God. With the Lord. Keep that line of communication open.
Yes.
Praise God. Keep things going. Praise God. Hallelujah. so you can have that relationship that God desires to have with you. And I notice he was an Old Testament prophet, Old Testament preacher. Praise God. Amen. And what he was saying. And when I turn to the New Testament and look, praise God, at scriptures just talking about seeking the Lord while he's near, praise God, I can help but to look and see what James said in James 4 and 8. He said something really similar. I'm going to know the Bible backs the books back up each other.
That's right. Praise God.
He said, draw near unto God, and he will draw near unto you.
Yes.
Praise God. You know, a young lady, praise God, asked me at work yesterday. She did ask and say, well, she said, Gary, I know you got to preach tomorrow. What are you going to preach about? I was so happy to tell her. I looked her in the face and I said, draw near unto God. And he'll draw near unto you. Lord, they done up. Oh, yeah. Yeah, wow, that sounds good. See, folks want a boy. They want all the glamour.
Yeah.
They want the title. Mm-hmm. They want to say I go to church. They want to say I'm a Christian. They want to say all this other stuff. But when it comes down to doing what God said, when it comes down to sacrificing a little bit, when it comes down to giving him some praise, when it comes down to giving him some glory, praise God, they don't know anything about that. When it comes down to giving him their heart, come on now. When it come down to it, they don't know anything about it.
That's right.
God said, draw near unto me. Woo! Come on now. And James said to him, draw near unto God. He made a promise. Praise God. If you draw near unto him, he'll draw near unto you.
Yes.
Praise God. Things that, amen, may not be working out like you say they should work out. If you just turn it over to the Lord, step out on faith. Hallelujah. God will work it out.
Yes,
praise
will.
God. Hallelujah. God is right there. Amen. He's right in the midst. Praise God. Of your circumstance and of your situation. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. I remember a situation in the scripture. Praise God. Amen. In Acts, when Paul and Silas was locked up in a Roman jail.
All right.
Hallelujah. Mm-hmm. Praise God. And they began to praise God in the midst of being locked up.
Yes.
They praised God in the midst of all the things, all the trouble that was going on in their life. They praised God even though they was in jail. Hallelujah. They praised God anyway.
Yes.
And they praised and they begin to sing praises unto God. Hallelujah. Glory to God. See, some folks don't think that, amen, when they're going through something, hallelujah, they don't know how to praise God.
Huh.
Woe is me. Folks looking at me funny. Why are things happening so bad on my... You're focusing on the wrong stuff.
All right.
Don't focus on that stuff.
Mm-hmm.
Praise God. Pulling on all that up. Amen. Forget about all that stuff.
Mm-hmm.
Yes. Hallelujah.
Jesus.
That woman, the fallen Silas said, listen, we're going to praise God. We're going to sing praises. They don't know what God's going to do. Don't underestimate God. Don't miss the opportunity. Praise God, you never know what God's going to do.
That's right.
Hallelujah. I remember the old preaching, I say that sometimes. Amen. Elder Goodall. Amen. You talk about love to praise God.
Amen.
Amen. When he comes into the church, he's clapping his hands. Amen. When he's first stepping into the door, praise God. Seems like a smile on his face. Amen. Like I made it to the house of the Lord.
Yes.
Amen. I was glad when they said unto me,
yes,
let us go into the house of the Lord.
Amen.
Praise God. Amen. Man got up, praise God, and been preaching one time. And his wife, he said, asked him the question, I don't know how you can clap your hands and jump up and down and praise God in that church. You knowing that we got all these bills. Praise God. Bill collectors calling. We can't do that. And half sick and all that. You going to church and praise God. You acting like you know. Yeah, none of this stuff affect you. He said, let me tell you something. Woo! It's like, I'm glad you asked that question. See, a lot of times folks miss out because they don't communicate.
All right.
They don't communicate. If they just, praise God, open up the door of the communication, the window of the communication, and communicate, you can get a lot of stuff out.
That's right.
You're like, I'm glad you asked that question. You've probably been harboring that on the heart and, praise God, getting all upset. He said, honey, let me tell you something. When I go in the house of the Lord, I forget about all of that stuff. Mm-hmm. All of that stuff is second nature. I'll leave it outside. I'll leave it to them. Let them worry about it. Praise God. They put the worry on me. I'll put the worry back on them. Let them worry about it. I'll come into the house of the Lord so I can pray. So I can pray. So I can lift them up. I'm not going to focus on that stuff.
Jesus.
Woo! That stuff will always happen. Mm-hmm. That's life. You don't think you're going to experience that stuff? Everybody's going to experience it.
Amen.
Praise God. Hallelujah.
Amen.
That's life. These men, praise God, were locked up in a jail cell. They ain't committing no crime. How you going to make a law against God? I mean, think about it. Make no law against God. They hadn't committed no crime. But praise God, they begin to praise Him. They begin, hallelujah. Paul and Silas begin to praise Him in the midnight hour. Sing praises to God. All of a sudden, they heard a little noise. Praise God while they was praising Him. I believe they just kept on praising Him. All of a sudden, the earth started to quake. The earth ground started to shake. The prison door started to fall open. Praise God, the place started to be attacked. Everything that they knew was safe wasn't safe anymore. All of a sudden, God was involved. God wanted to get in the midst of your circumstance.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Lord.
He wanted to be right there in the middle of it.
Yes.
Whatever you're going through, whatever the circumstances, it's always something. Praise God.
Amen.
I remember a guy, praise God, on the job told me one time, praise God, said, well, Gary, I'm getting out of the service. I got a certain kind of disability, and praise God, I'm getting out and this and that. I said, oh, I'm going to keep getting my prayers and whatnot. He said, yeah, but everything's fine. Man, they're going to take care of me for the rest of my life. I don't have to worry about insurance. They're going to give me this kind of check. This is going to be more than enough to do what I want. I said, hey, don't get too carried away. He said, what do you mean? I said, you're going to always have trouble.
Yeah.
Now, you're going to always have problems. Praise God. Amen. He never forgot that. And from that point on, praise God. Amen. Amen. Circumstance, situation, some things happen, praise God, in his life and his family. Praise God. Amen. He constantly called back, praise God, for prayer. Went through a divorce, praise God. Lost a child. A number of things happened to this individual. Praise God. And you cannot take this thing for granted.
That's it.
Praise God, you always got to keep the Lord near, praise God. His presence is right there. He always listening for that call. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Be jealous, praise God. Amen, Paul and Silas, praise. That earthquake shook that place that night.
Yep.
The doors of the prison, praise God, came open.
Yes. Yes.
Everybody was exposed.
Yes.
Praise God. The guard of the prison was so shook up by it. He didn't know what to do. He said, all these prisoners, praise God, amen, is probably gone and I'm on duty. And the Roman bars, Caesar, they didn't take no stuff. If you were the guard that night, praise God, and you was responsible, your life is at stake. And it's Roman. Praise God, this century, this individual knew what his fate, believed and knew what his fate was about.
Mm-hmm.
Praise God, and he took out his sword, and he was going to kill himself. Praise God. And Paul said, do yourself no harm. We're all here. And that man came, praise God, hallelujah, came calling, said, why, Jesus, I've never seen nothing like this. He said, what must I do to be saved?
Yes. Yeah.
And that's when Paul, Romans 10 and 8, praise the Lord. That's when Paul, hallelujah, made the statement. Praise God. Ezra 1:4. It said, for Moses described the righteousness which is in the law, that the man which does these things shall live by them. But the righteousness which is of faith speak on this wise. Say not in your heart, who shall ascend unto heaven, that is to bring Christ down from above, or who shall descend into the deep, that is to bring up Christ again from the dead. But what does it say? The word is near you. The word is nigh you. Even in your mouth and in your heart. That is the word of faith which we preach. Hallelujah. That if you will confess, if you shall confess, if you shall open your mouth and communicate, if you should have a conversation, praise God with God. Confess with your mouth the Lord Jesus and believe in your heart.
Thank
you, Lord. Woo! That God has risen him from the dead. You shall be saved.
Yes, yes.
He said, this is the process.
Jesus.
For with the heart man believe unto righteousness. Mm-hmm. You have to be changed in the heart. Praise God. With the heart man believe unto righteousness, and with the mouth salvation. And with the mouth, confession is made unto salvation. For the scripture says, whosoever believe on him shall not be ashamed. There's no difference between the Jew and the Greek. For the same Lord over all is rich unto all who call upon him. For whosoever call upon the name of the Lord shall be saved. Amen.
Yes.
Praise God. Shall be saved. Believe on the Lord. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Glory to God.
Amen.
Praise
Amen.
The Lord. The hallelujah.
Thank you, Jesus.
As we look unto him, the author and the finisher of our faith. Praise God. Hallelujah. And he comes back, praise God, and says the same thing as, praise God, Acts 16 and 31. Praise the Lord. Praise God. As I was finishing that up, I praise God. 30-29 says, then he called for a light and sprang up in it, and he came trembling and fell down before Paul and Silas and brought them out and said, sirs, what must I do?
Yes.
Woo. To be saved. And I said, believe on the Lord Jesus Christ.
Yes.
And you shall be saved. And your house. And they spoke unto him the words of the Lord. Hallelujah. And to all that were in his house. Praise God. And he took them the same hour of the same of that night and washed and was baptized. And he and all straightway and brought. When he had brought them into his house, he set meat before them and rejoiced, believing in God with all his house. The Lord is near.
Yes, he is.
Yes, he is.
The Lord is near.
Yes, he is.
Praise God. They used to sing a little song, don't forget the family prayer. Don't forget, praise God, and leave God out. Praise God of your situation, of your circumstance. Don't miss out on the opportunity. Praise God. But God is near.
Yes.
Praise God. In your circumstance.
Yes.
God is a specialist. Hallelujah. God works through, praise God, those situations and circumstance. God's yet got a purpose. Hallelujah. That is building. Hallelujah. Yeah. Praise God. He's building us up. Praise God. God is building relationships. Hallelujah. Maybe an individual you haven't talked to in quite some time. God is putting it on your heart. I want you to rekindle that relationship. And maybe somebody wants you to call. Maybe somebody wants you to talk to. Praise God. God is rekindling that relationship. Praise God. God is saying, I want you to get close to him because I want you to show him something.
That's right.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
That
the Lord is with you. Praise God. Wherever you go. Praise God. The opportunity to draw nigh unto God. Amen. This is the day. This is the time. This is the age. Praise God. Amen. Today is the day of salvation. Yes. Praise God. The time is now to draw near unto the Lord.
Amen.
God's got a purpose, praise God, that he's using us for. God's got a purpose that he's using your life for. Hallelujah. To be the salt of the earth, the light of the world, praise God. Amen. And that's going to mean you're involved. God is involved.
Amen.
Okay, we're so used to it. I mean, this generation loving. They've loved it down through the years. Spectator sports. Praise God. Where you get, praise God, 100,000 people, amen, in a stadium somewhere, watching somebody, amen, do something with a football or a basketball. Praise God, and excitement. But praise God, God don't want a spectator sport out of us.
All right.
He wants us to
amen.
Be involved. He wants us to be out on the court. He wants us to be out on the playing field. He wants us to be involved doing different things. He wants to run plays through us. Praise God. He wants to make a difference. Praise God, in the circumstances and in the relationships that we have. Amen. He want to do that through us.
Yes.
All right.
It says, "Send, draw near unto me. Draw near." Building that relationship. Let us stand to our feet.